Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of a remote procedure calls, guys. That is nothing but RPC. So basically, this is a common word which you will be listening whenever you are discussing about distributed systems or networking, right?
Yes.
So RPC is a protocol that one program can use to request a service from another program located in another computer on the network. Okay? Without having to understand the network details. So assume that you wrote a program, guys. Okay. And your friend also wrote a program. Okay. And you both are working on the same project. So he also wrote the code. You also wrote the code. So in your code, you used a function called add, assume. Okay. So add x comma y. So you wrote call x comma add x comma y, but you did not write the whole code of it. Your friend wrote the code for it. So now you want to communicate with his system. So basically in the network, you want to establish a connection between you and your friend's system, and you want to call a function from your system to his system. So this calling, the concept is nothing but remote procedure call, guys. So that is the exact definition which I drawn here. Okay. Okay. So a procedure call is also called as a function call, also subroutine call. RPC uses the client server model. So he is the client and he could be the server. So in that way. Right? Yes. Okay. So if you want me to draw a small flow diagram, it will be in this way, guys. So the client will be calling the procedure. Okay. And the server will be receiving it. So it is in idle state, and here also it is in idle state. So the request will be accepted, and based on the local procedure call, everything will be done. The code will be executed, and the result will be replied back. So in that way, it will be working. So you see, this is a simple diagram, guys. Guys, we'll be drawing three different diagrams, guys. This is a simple flow. Then we will be discussing a block diagram, and then we'll be discussing in detail diagram. So how it really works. So these three things we'll be discussing in this lecture. So don't worry, guys. Okay. Okay. So basically this RPC includes five different elements, guys, or faces, you can say. Okay. So the first is nothing but the client. The second is nothing but the client stub. Okay. The RPC runtime. Okay. The server stub or the server. I hope everyone knows what is a client and what is a server. Okay. So what is this stub? Your first question will be. So stub is nothing but a piece of a code used to convert parameters. Okay. So it is used to convert some parameters and all those things. We'll be using this client stub, guys. Okay. Normal stub. Okay. If it is on the client side, we'll be calling it as client. If it is on the server side, server stub. And this RPC runtime is nothing but a communication package, guys. So basically you need to have some common things, right? So this is the common thing between both of you, right? Yes. So now let us go through steps. Okay. So the client. So it is user process initiated with RPC. The client makes a perfect normal call that invokes a corresponding procedure in a client stub. So basically client will talk and he will be informing it to the client stub, guys. Okay. So now client stub, on receiving the request, it packs the request into message and asks the RPC runtime to send. So basically the flow will be in this way, guys. So observe it carefully. It is really simple, guys. Okay. So initially you will be calling. Okay. So once you call, you will be doing the process of packing, guys. So that is done by your client stub. So client stub will do packaging, and this packet or packet will be shared using RPC runtime. It will be sent to the server side. The server will be receiving it and it will be passing it to unpacking. So unpacking is done and it will be returning the value, and the process will continue, guys. So it will be returned and again packing is done. It will be sent again, unpacking is done, and it's opened. So this is the whole process, guys. Guys, with an example, I'll be explaining you this part. Don't worry. Okay. Okay. So on receiving the request, it packs the request into message and asks RPC runtime to send. Okay. So once receiving the result, it unpacks and the result the passes to the client. So basically here each and every phase is having two steps, right, guys, right? So here packing is done, here unpacking is done. So packing is done for calling function. So basically whenever you are calling something, it will pack and it will send. Similarly, whatever is received, it will unpack and it will return the result. So that's what I have written here. So this is the second step, guys. Okay. Similarly, RPC runtime, it is nothing but it will be transmitting the messages between the client and server. Okay. Similarly, the server stub, it unpacks a call request and makes a perfect normal call to invoke the appropriate procedure in the server. Okay. On receiving the result, it will do the reverse process. That is nothing but it will pack and it will send to RPC. So the server, what it is doing, guys, on server side, it is unpacking. Okay. And it is packing. So both the processes you can write. Similarly, the server will be executing and returning the result. That's it. So if you want me to do with an example, so here I have written with an example, guys. So this, in this I have written the even the procedure call also. Okay, so here is the client and he is doing a procedure call. K is equals to add of I comma j. Okay, so packing is nothing but here we will be dividing it into multiple parts. That is nothing but procedure. So what is the procedure name? That is nothing but add. And here we are having two integers. That is nothing but int I comma int j. So this message is sent by this path and it is received and the packet will be unpacked. So by unpacking you will be getting this result. So that will be processed by the server and you will be getting the result back. Okay, so that is the exact steps which I have written here, guys. So basically I have indicated here 1, 2 and all the things. So here we are having a 1, so that is nothing but client call procedure. Here we are having a 2, that is nothing but stub built message packet, and 3 is nothing but messages sent across the network. Okay, so it is sent across the network, and here we are having a 4, that is nothing but server hands the message to the stub. Okay, so the stub has received. And 5 is nothing but it will be doing unpacking, okay, and the result will be given. So stub makes the local calls to add. Now the answer will be returned in the reverse way. So basically it will be returned back in this way to the client. So in this way the whole RPC will work, guys. So I hope everyone got a clear idea about RPC, right? So we took two examples indirectly, guys. So I hope everyone is clear with this RPC. So in the next lecture we will be discussing about some issues with this RPC, guys. And we will also discuss the advantages and disadvantages also in the next lecture. Okay. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.